partnering with public health in the treatment of tuberculosis. The goal of this program is to clarify how public health and clinics work in partnership for the management of TB. By the end of this presentation, viewers will be able to describe the referral process for active and latent TB to public health, along with resources available to patients, and understand how the partnership between clinical and public health providers works for the successful management of active and latent TB cases. Here's a quick refresher on the difference between active and latent TB. For a more detailed overview, check out our TB 101 program. The treatment of choice for cases of active TB is a combination of the antimicrobial drugs isoniazid, rifampin, pyrazinamide, and ethambutol. It's important to remember that tuberculosis drugs have to be taken regularly and consistently, typically for a period of 6 to 12 months. If you suspect TB disease in a patient, you're required by law to report this to the health department within 24 hours. Please ensure that all patients suspected of having TB disease are properly isolated until they can get further follow-up. Give them masks to wear and tell them to stay home until public health or a provider has contacted them for further follow-up. To report a suspected case of TB, call Public Health Madison and Dane County at 608-266-4821. During the weekend, call 267-3913 and ask them to page the public health manager on call. If you get a voicemail, do not leave a message. Just hang up and try again in a few minutes. In order to release the patient from isolation, you'll need the result of 3 sputum specimens collected at least 8 hours apart, including 1 early morning sample. If possible, order a chest x-ray and begin the medication therapy, rifampin, isoniazid, ethambutol, and pyrazinamide. If appropriate, refer the patient to an infectious disease provider. The legal responsibility of the health department in the control of active cases of tuberculosis is to ensure that all people who are suspected of having tuberculosis are identified, evaluated, and isolated promptly, and that an appropriate course of treatment is prescribed and completed successfully. Public health will not only assist with isolation issues, but also provide full case management from diagnosis to cure. We'll also provide medication free of charge, monitor for side effects, and assure adherence. Another important aspect of our job is to make sure that the therapy is directly observed by public health staff, which is also known as directly observed therapy or DOT. We will also perform IGRA or skin testing for those who've had contact with the patient and also provide patient education. To diagnose latent TB infection, you need to choose one method of testing. IGRAs are the preferred method for testing for those older than 5 years old. A positive IGRA or skin test and a normal chest x-ray will be indicative of latent TB infection. Another indication of latent infection is the patient must also be free from TB disease symptoms. If not, sputum samples may need to be collected before starting latent TB infection treatment. There are 3 medication regimens to choose from when treating latent TB infection. One involves isoniazid and rifampin, given once weekly as a combination drug treatment. This treatment is 12 weeks long, and the therapy must also be directly observed by public health staff. The second regimen is isoniazid, which is a once-daily treatment lasting 9 months. The third is rifampin, which is a once-daily treatment lasting 4 months. Public health is able to case manage latent TB infection treatment. If qualified, patients can have medications provided at no cost. Public health is able to provide DOT for the weekly isoniazid and rifampin regimen. We also monitor for adherence and side effects on a weekly or monthly basis and provide patient education on latent TB infection and treatment options. Medication order forms can be found on the Public Health Madison and Dane County website or the Wisconsin TB Program's website. Forms should be completed in their entirety and faxed to Public Health Madison and Dane County at 608-266-4858. If you have any questions, please call Public Health Madison and Dane County at 608-266-4821 and ask for the TB nurse on call. Leave a message on the confidential voicemail, and a TB nurse will call you back as soon as possible before the end of the business day. For programmatic questions, or if you're unable to get in touch with an on-call nurse, please call Kate Luther, TB Program Supervisor, at 608-243-0317. For a step-by-step guide on collecting a home sputum specimen, please see our video on YouTube, available in 19 different languages. Staff at the Wisconsin TB Program is also available for consultation at 608-266-9692. The Mayo TB Center is our regional consultation hospital, and a consult can be requested through the State TB Program or by calling 1-855-360-1466. You can also reach them by email at tbcenter@mayo.edu. In conclusion, let's review the key points that are important to remember from this presentation. You should know and understand the difference between active and latent TB. All patients suspected of TB disease must be reported to the local health department within 24 hours. You must isolate all patients suspected of TB disease until further follow-up can be done. Public Health Madison Dane County can assist with case management of active and latent TB treatment, including providing medications at no cost to the patient. IGRA testing is the preferred method of TB testing for those over the age of 5 years. If you have any TB-related questions, feel free to call Public Health Madison Dane County at 608-266-4821. Thanks for watching.